could manage. And these lists came with rather dismaying regularity to include Stirling. So there's a slight edginess, a slight nervousness, a slight provisionality about the early years of the university. And then 1981, of course, came the famous or infamous cuts. And for many at the time, it seemed as though they might indeed be the university's death knell. But they weren't. Under the leadership of successive principals, the university has come to establish for itself a recognised and a distinctive place in higher education in Scotland and in the UK, with a proven record of achievement in research and in learning and in teaching, a record that in many respects even has been unrivaled. And so it is that in those league tables, for which we have no regard whatsoever, we now regularly come immediately after the ages, fifth in Scotland. And they, of course, have been at it for 400 or more years. So it's not bad going. But none of that, of course, would have been possible without the commitment, without the good sense, without the vision, and indeed without the optimism of Sir Alan and his colleagues. So we owe him and those colleagues a very great debt. And I invite you to express your appreciation of that and for the lecture that we have done.